conversation.
My name is Jamie Mickelson.
My first name is David. My last name is Van Nieuwenhuisen.
I'm Dan Verada.
I'm Nicholas Rini.
Benjamin Hoosier.
My name is Hassan Sauli. That's HASSANSAOULI. And I am a student here at RCC.
Senior year of high school. Like back then, I guess the whole like scene trend was going on, and then that like sort of trended at that school immediately after. So I guess that's kind of when I first heard of it.
You know, I was actually, I think, a little behind the times. I kind of heard about it my senior year, maybe junior. But if it was junior, it's probably the end of junior year. So I was a little behind on that.
Probably sometime in high school, around when all the sketch comedy people started making fun of it. You know, when the archetype, I suppose, started showing up in like YouTube videos and on things like Saturday Night Live or Mad TV or something.
So the first time I heard the term hipster, I was a senior in high school, towards the end of my senior year. So I have this friend Marissa, and we're just talking, and somehow she brought up like that I was a low key hipster. She said, "You're kind of like a low key hipster," and I was like, low-key hipster. I didn't even know what a hipster was. It's the first time I heard the word. So I heard like a comparison of me to like people who she considered a full-on hipster. So I just kind of made the comparison and kind of tried to see why I was considered a low-key hipster, and just don't really understand. It's kind of a really broad word. I don't know, but people throw it around like nothing.
I would have to say around middle of high school, near the end. Not entirely sure as to when exactly it was, but it was relatively late in high school.
Well, I've heard it for a long time, like from a good number of years. I never was really familiar with it in the sense that I never really understood what it meant. I just thought it was another like really broad label. I knew that it was used to describe a lot of people who usually like good art or good music, but it was so broad that it never really seemed like an objective term to me.
It's interesting. There's a lot of cool concepts about it that I like. I enjoy, you know, the whole hipster, I guess, trend. There's a lot of art involved and music, and it's sort of just kind of where I fall in. It's very artsy, which I like.
I thought it was pretty cool. The style of dressing and everything was kind of how I dress already, and I love the music. So I thought originally it was pretty cool. Kind of different now, but you know.
I think it's just one of those words used for lack of better word. You know, it's a very blanket term. It applies to many, many people, and I think we use it interchangeably with words like, you know, smarty pants or nerd, you know. Whenever somebody presents an abundance of knowledge about a very particular or specific subject, they're considered, you know, nerdy or know-it-all-y, you know. But, you know, I suppose hipster is just a more culturally aware way of saying that, you know, and of conveying that idea.
I don't know. I don't identify myself as a hipster. I don't know. I don't put a lot of weight on it. But I guess I would be considered one to many people, but it's just a word, whatever.
Hipster, I mean, people, I guess, refer to me as a hipster occasionally, but it's nothing that I'll take a second glance at a person for, or I'll just think about it later. It'll just be like somebody calling me tall or outspoken or something along the lines of that. It's just, it is what it is, and it's nothing that important to me.
But it's just a fashion. It has nothing to do with like a person. So, and to me, fashion statements, like, it wouldn't really say anything about the person. So,
at first I thought it was just like, I don't know, just another stupid trend, but I just kind of just stopped caring.
Nowadays, hipsters are just such a broad thing. Like, you see them all over the place. I mean, I see them all over campus. So,
I don't know. I don't identify myself as a hipster. I don't put a lot of weight on it.
Oh, I think it's been a phenomenon that's been around since the dawn of man. Ever since somebody has had an idea that differs from the norm, people have had an equivalent to hipsters. You know, the term hipster, I suppose, just started coming up again recently, but there's always been some sort of equivalent to it. I think that's just one of the many types of personalities that exist within the human paradigm of personalities. Mm.
There's no real definitive answer or motivation to fix it. It's just that we want to be different. It's just a lack of identity, usually. And so we try to create our own identity. And in doing so, it usually gets bottled up and covered over by a generalization that comes out of it. It's inevitable.
I think people just get conditioned in a lot of ways, even when they're interested in like counterculture movements or artistic movements, they're still being conditioned to think that there's boundaries when it comes to any type of art, and there never is. And so, like, I don't know, I'm not exactly sure where it comes from. I just think that if, as far as the derogatory meaning to it, and like the fact that people are like anti, it probably has to do with people being anti-intellectual in America. I'm sure that has something to do with it. And also the fact that mainstream culture has always been bad, and so kids are always trying to find an alternative to what they're being fed, because it sucks all the time.